Today, I am going to teach you university problem from the queuing theory chapter. So welcome to my YouTube channel, Mechanical Engineering Management. Like, share and subscribe. So let's see description of the problem. Arrival rate of telephone calls at a telephone booth follows Poisson distribution with an average times of 9 minutes between two consecutive calls. The length of call is assumed to be exponentially distributed with mean of 3 minutes. Now the question. Determine the probability that a person arriving at the telephone booth have to wait. Second, find the average queue length that is formed from time to time. Third, the telephone company will install a second booth when convinced that an arrival would expect to have to wait at least 4 minutes for the phone. Find increase in rate of arrival. So this is the description. Now here it is given to you, arrival rate of telephone calls at a telephone booth follows Poisson distribution with an average time of 9 minutes. So that is called as the arrival rate. So very simple. You can understand now 9 minutes per one customer. So if I want to find how many customers for 1 minute, then it is very simple. 1 divided by 9. So that is your arrival rate and that is denoted by lambda. Next, the length of call is assumed to be exponentially distributed with mean of 3 minutes and that is called as service rate. So I can say 3 minutes per one customer. So if I want to find how many customers during 1 minute. So very simple, multiply these 2 divided by 3 and that is called as the service rate and it is denoted by mu. So once you got this mu and lambda, then definitely you should go for the utilization factor rho and that is lambda by mu. So if you put these both values in this equation and simplify, then you will get rho as 0.333. So anyone from the queuing problem, generally these are the common step. First you have to identify lambda, then mu and then find the utilization factor. Now next, first determine the probability that a person arriving at the telephone booth have to wait. So now we are going to find the first answer. This is already we have lambda, mu and rho. So first one, probability that a person arriving at the telephone booth have to wait. So have to wait, that means what? The telephone booth is busy, that means service station is busy, that means the probability for the busy station, and as we know that that is called as the utilization of the telephone booth or service station, and that's why you can understand it is exactly equal to the utilization factor rho. Now next one, find the average queue length that is formed from time to time. So very simple, that is called as the average queue length and that is denoted by L, so that I can say LQ is equal to rho into LS, because of here we want to find the queue length, that's why it is Q. So first we have to find the LS. So now I am going to find the LS and that is equal to lambda upon mu minus lambda. Lambda and mu both we have. So if you put it over here and then simplify, then you will get LS is 0.5 customer. So now I can put rho as 0.33 and LS as 0.5 in this equation. So I will get LQ is equal to 0.167 customers. So this is your second answer, average queue length. Now third one, the telephone company will install a second booth when convinced that an arrival would expect to have to wait at least 4 minutes for the phone. So now your waiting time is given to you as 4 minutes and we want to find what should be the new arrival rate, and at last we will find increase in the arrival rate. So now let's see, waiting time that is now given to you as 4 minutes. So this is your new waiting time in the queue and corresponding arrival rate is denoted by lambda dash. So this is your new arrival rate corresponding to waiting time Q as 4 minutes. by installing a second booth. And you know that these all formula. New waiting time in the queue. So if I put rho as lambda by mu, then here lambda dash is the new arrival rate into WS, that means 1 upon mu minus lambda dash. And here it is given to you, new waiting time is 4 minutes. So if I put it over here, WQ as 4, lambda dash as it is, and service rate is 1 by 3. So that you will get new arrival rate lambda dash as 0.19. So previously lambda, that means arrival rate is 1 by 9. Now it is 0.19. So now I can find the increase in arrival rate. So increase in arrival rate is equal to new arrival rate minus old arrival rate. So lambda dash is equal to 0.19 and old one, that is 1 by 9, and that is 0.111. So if you simplify, then increase in arrival rate as 0.079. So this is the increase in arrival rate as 0.079 customers per minute. If you want to see more videos on operation research, then subscribe my YouTube channel and go to playlist. So thanks my dear friends, press the like button to appreciate this video.